Because guess what? Knowledge and wisdom is going to be the stability of the evil times to come. So we have to receive this knowledge, man. We have to receive this understanding now. Because all hell's going to break loose at any given time here in America, man. I know different brothers have noticed, but, you know, cops have been circling around us more, driving by, you know, peeping us out, man. Because there is going to come a time in the near future where the men of the Lord, they're going to be looked at as terrorists. You got people taking pictures. You know, you got people being paid to take pictures, man. Let's face it, you know that's happening. And we're just normal, plain normal guys, man, who work jobs, who have families, who just live basic lives, man. But you have the so-called white man behind the scenes really plotting to take us down because they know that this truth is a threat to their society. Okay, rather they believe the truth, which I'm sure a lot of them Edomites believe it, but you still have those who are still stubborn to the fact of having a hardened heart, kind of like what the Lord did to Pharaoh, man. Okay? If any of you lack wisdom, let him ask of God that giveth to all men liberally and upbraideth not, and it shall be given him. But let him ask in faith, not wavering. For he that wavereth is like a wave of the sea, driven with the wind and tossed. So pretty much, don't go praying to God for wisdom, but you lack in faith. You all shaky and shit, man. If you're going to come to the Lord about something, you better come to the Lord wholeheartedly. Don't come to him partial, man. Don't play with the Lord, man. Just like if, you know, let's say you get into an altercation with an Edomite, and then later on you wishing death upon that Edomite. Let's say the Lord kill him, man. And then you end up feeling sorry for the devil. End up boo-hooing and crying. Oh, I can't believe he actually died, man. I didn't think he's going to really do it. No, man. If you're going to come to the Lord, come to him wholeheartedly, man. Because the scriptures tell you, let's just get it. James 1 and 8. A double-minded man is unstable in all his ways. So when you come to the Lord, you can't be wavering, man. You can't be double-minded. You can't be partial, okay? You don't walk around town with one butt cheek. So you don't do nothing half-assed, man. If you go and ask the Lord something, ask him in sincerity and in faith and know that he's going to deliver you what you prayed for. If you ask for wisdom, know in your mind, in your spirit, the Lord is going to work his wonder and do that for you, man. It may not happen instantly, but know it's going to happen. Okay? Faith is highly important. Don't be wavering. Don't be double-minded, man. Okay? Be sure of the prophecies. Be sure that what you're teaching is the truth. Be sure that no matter who sees you out here teaching, you're not going to be ashamed or, you know, you might be speaking and then all because some fine-ass woman comes walking or driving by, you lower your voice because then you get a little ashamed a little bit. No, man, don't be ashamed. Okay? You got to be confident. You got to stand in boldness, man. And pray to the Lord for that wisdom and he will increase it, which is something I need to do myself. Right? Because I'm not very good at remembering scriptures. I'm really not. All right? But I do what I can. And the Lord increases me through time more and more, through increments, man. All right? This is the book of John. And ye now therefore have sorrow, but I will see you again, and your heart shall rejoice, and your joy no man taketh from you. And in that day ye shall ask me nothing. Verily, verily, I say unto you, whatsoever ye shall ask the Father in my name, he will give it you. So in the kingdom, we're going to know all things. was it when this happened? Hey, Yahweh Shai, how was this planet put together? You're going to know these things because it's going to be placed within you in the spirit, because the elect are the first fruit, are the first fruits after the first fruit, which is Yahweh Shai, the first creations, okay, that were created, who were putting together different planets and the stars, elements and things like that, man. So when you think about it, you had Yahweh Shai and the band of angels, which also goes into the elect, who created the planets. So really the only thing that Yahweh really created, if you think about it, was Eve, which was given to Adam, right? And then Yahweh Shai. Everything else was created under him, man. Everything you're looking at right now. So seeing that, knowing in the kingdom to come, you're going to know everything. The things you don't know right now, it don't matter. It's unnecessary. All right? When the Lord feels the need to give us all that wisdom, he's going to give it to us, man. Because there's things, if we knew right now, it would bug you out because it's heavy. There's a lot of things out there that will put you in a heavy mentality, and you might become so mentally depressed, you kill yourself, man. There's some things out there, it's best that you don't know right now. Okay? And just stick to the things the Lord gave you. Alright? And for some of you who get messed up and say, Yahweh created Yahweh Shai and Eve, that's it? Well, what I'm saying is this, think about it. Yahweh Shai was Adam, man. Okay? Adam was already here on earth in the flesh. So it was Yahweh that decided to give him a woman. So think about it, man. Yahweh created Yahweh Shai, and he created the woman. But everything else was created through Yahweh Shai and the rest of the elect. That's heavy. But guess what? Whether you know that or not, it doesn't really profit your salvation per se. But it's cool to know things like that. But you know, being meek, you know, the Lord just drops little jewels on you like that, man. And it may not be necessary, but it's still amazing to know it, man. But you keep enduring, you keep pushing, you keep doing the work. Don't be trying to be all deep all the time, okay? Keep things simple. The Lord just gonna, he gonna feed you things, man. Because that's just how he works. And the glory which thou gavest me, I have given them, that they may be one, even as we are one. Oh, that's the wrong verse. Excuse me. That was 17, this is 16. And ye now therefore have sorrow, but I will see you again, and your heart shall rejoice, and your joy will be taken from you. So the man around that time who were with Yahweh Shai, you gotta think, they didn't want him to depart, man. Yahweh Shai was with us right now, and then it came to a point where he had to depart from us. We'd be sad, just like when we're around brothers, and then brothers might be visiting other brothers. It comes to that point where you might have to separate, you go back home. You know, it's a sad situation, man. But guess what? In the kingdom, we don't have to go through that sorrow. But nevertheless, it was more profitable for Yahweh Shai to leave us at that time too, because through him leaving, he would be sent unto us as the comforter. He would be sent unto us to give us those mysteries through the spirit. Okay? Things that he could have did in the flesh, but it was still more profitable that he left, because now he wasn't in the flesh at all. He's in the spirit right now. So when he returns, he's not going to meet us as a man. He's going to meet us as an angelic form. But guess what? Through knowing these mysteries, through knowing the truth, a man is going to be delivered. Not through knowing the deepest mysteries you can think of, but by knowing these scriptures, the mysteries of the scriptures, man, we're going to be delivered and abiding by it the best that we can. That's beautiful, man. All right? The Lord didn't raise us up to be ninjas. to go around, you know, being physical, to be heroic in a sense of grabbing guns and trying to take down this civilization, because we will lose, man. Okay? We're not those Israelites from the past who constantly were going against the powers that be. Okay? We're not as it's slipping my mind right now. Satan took it from me. Them zealots, okay, who had a zeal for the Lord, but in a carnal mentality, not in a spiritual mentality, because you can have a zeal for the Lord spiritually, but you can also have a zeal for the Lord physically. But that's not going to really work out for you too well, because right now we're in a condition to where we need to wait on the Lord, okay? But nevertheless, like I said, through these scriptures, that's where the real wisdom is. But a lot of people in this world, they believe that following after the ways of Esau, that's where the wisdom is. Okay? Sirach 19. This is Sirach 19 and 22. The knowledge of wickedness is not wisdom, neither at any time the counsel of sinners prudence. So the knowledge of wickedness is not wisdom. That's why when you go into the Illuminati, they're considered to be the illuminated ones. But really, they're illuminated in wickedness, yes. But they're not wise whatsoever. They're really fools, because they promote wickedness. They follow after wickedness. They are the wicked. Okay? So seeing that, it's showing you that they're fools, man. And the scriptures also tell you that wisdom is too high for a fool, man. Okay? And how the wicked will not understand. So the wicked, they can hear the scriptures, but they're not going to understand the scriptures fully. Although, don't get me wrong, the scriptures does say how the elites are wiser than Daniel. So they do know these scriptures. Don't get me wrong. But I guess what I'm trying to say is, although they might know some of these deep mysteries, okay? Let me read this again. Sirach 19 and 22. The knowledge of wickedness is not wisdom. So seeing that the knowledge of wickedness is not wisdom, all right, the so-called white man is promoting wickedness all throughout the earth because he's a goddamn fool, man. But then the Illuminati, which claim to be the illuminated ones, they're not the illuminated ones in righteousness. They're the illuminated ones in wickedness. So really, they're in darkness, man. Okay? Really, their light is of darkness. Okay? Through the Spirit. If you're not about Yahweh or Yahweh Shah, you're about wickedness, man. And if you believe in anything that opposes the scriptures, you're a fool and you're of wickedness. The knowledge of wickedness is not wisdom, neither at any time the counsel of sinners prudence. And two-thirds of Israel, they're evil, man. Now, when it comes to being evil, they're wise, which is not wise at all. But our people are wise when it comes to doing wrong. When it comes to being evil, you know exactly what to do and how to do it. You know how to break in a house. You know how to serve dope to your people. You know how to do a lot of wickedness, but doing the right thing, that's not in a lot of your vocabulary. Okay? But as the scripture says, the knowledge of wickedness is not wisdom. Let me read that again, just so I don't twist it up. Sirach 19 and 22. The knowledge of wickedness is not wisdom, neither at any time the counsel of sinners prudence. There is a wickedness, and the same an abomination. There is a fool wanting in wisdom. Okay? He that hath small understanding and fear with God is better than one that hath much wisdom and transgresseth the law of the Most High. So you can know the Bible all throughout, and you're not following the ways of the Lord. It's all in